home is where you should feel the safest. But what if your home vanished beneath you? Life in Bangladesh is defined by the delta of the mighty Ganges and Brahmaputra rivers. Nearly 80% of the population lives here. But as the effects of climate change become more severe, nearly all of Bangladesh's 174 million people are threatened by sea level rise and stronger cyclones. In May 2024, Cyclone Remal slammed into Bangladesh, flooding coastal areas and overflowing major rivers. Nearly 20 million people were affected, with over 6 million needing aid.
In the coastal zone, we have lots of cyclone shelter, which is built by the government agency. So we have a very good warning system in Bangladesh to predict cyclone. There's volunteers take these people to the shelter so that during cyclone they are safe, but in some cases you have to make little bit adjustment according to the local condition.
As a cyclone-prone, low-lying country, Bangladesh faces a constant battle against rising seas, devastating floods, storm surges, intense heat, and erratic monsoons, all of which are worsening with climate change. But as these threats grow, Bangladesh is putting in place robust disaster management systems to increase resilience in these vulnerable areas.
People, first of all, they don't like to move, leaving behind their asset and livestock, and they don't like to move.
Not everyone lives close to a cyclone shelter, and for some, leaving home can be difficult. To address this, UNEP CCC partnered with Bangladesh Rehabilitation Assistance Committee, or BRAC, to increase resilience. In 2022, this project was implemented in Bangladesh, supporting efforts to build climate-resilient housing, providing safer homes for those vulnerable to extreme weather. Prova Mrida moved into her climate-resilient house in 2024, just before Cyclone Remal.
আমি নিচের তলায় আমি গরু ছাগল ভেড়াই রাখতে পারিছি আর উপরে আমি আমার বাড়ি যারা আইছে লোকজন তাদের আমি উপরে রাখতে পারিছি.
The interesting part of this house is it doubles as a mini cyclone shelter whenever a cyclone or any tidal flood strikes. So people can stay here, at least around 35 to 40 people can stay here during a cyclone.
The houses have been designed specifically to withstand Bangladesh's climate extremes. 25-year sea level rise projections were used to set the foundation heights. To combat salinity from ocean surges, the bricks were soaked in tamarind water, a nature-based solution that enhances durability by preventing erosion. The houses have solar panels and rainwater systems for sustainable power and clean water, even in emergencies. So far, 37 houses have been built in 6 districts, 2 of which were led by UNEP. Nearly 1,000 people were able to shelter in them during Cyclone Remal. It's estimated more than 7,000 cyclone shelters are needed in Bangladesh, and the combined economic and social environmental benefits provided by these homes could prove to be a game changer.
Our resilience today and tomorrow is defined by the buildings and homes that we build. We must prioritize construction solutions that minimize emissions whilst also protecting people from extreme weather as the climate crisis intensifies. Climate resilient housing in Bangladesh shows what's possible when adaptation and mitigation go hand in hand from the inception stage. To build resilience and to safeguard people and their livelihoods, countries can integrate such approaches into their national climate plans and scale investments.
Our most important priority is economic development, but at the same time, if we want to maintain sustainability, then we have to also consider our environmental sustainability, environmental safeguards, and I think this climate resilient housing concept supported by UNEP can be a good foundation for future activities.
With more funding, initiatives like this can scale up, protecting Mrida, her neighbors, and millions more in climate vulnerable areas across Bangladesh. Every fraction matters.